The Fairchild Republic A10 Thunderbolt is a single-seat, twin-turbofan, straight-wing, subsonic attack aircraft developed by Fairchild Republic for the United States Air Force. The aircraft was designed to provide close air support to friendly ground troops by attacking armored vehicles, tanks, and other enemy ground forces. It is the only production-built aircraft designed solely for close air support to have served with the U.S. Air Force. Its secondary mission is to direct other aircraft in attacks on ground targets, a role called Forward Air Controller Airborne. Officially known as A-10 Thunderbolt, this aircraft is commonly nicknamed as the Warthog. Over 700 of these close support aircraft were built. A number of them are still operational. History and background. The development of conventionally armed attack aircraft in the United States stagnated after World War II, as design efforts for tactical aircraft focused on the delivery of nuclear weapons. As the U.S. military entered the Vietnam War, its main ground attack aircraft was the Korean War-era Douglas A-1 Sky Raider. A capable aircraft for its era, but it has a lot of flaws. The propeller-driven design was relatively slow and vulnerable to ground fire. It also had inadequate firepower. So, the lack of modern conventional attack capability prompted calls for a specialized attack aircraft. The Fairchild Republic team, or now a part of Northrop Grumman Corporation, was awarded a study contract in the 1960s to define requirements for a new close air support aircraft, rugged and survivable, to protect combat troops on the ground. This initial study was followed up by a prototype development contract for the AX, and a final fly-off competition, resulting in the selection of the A-10 Thunderbolt II. The A-10A aircraft first flew on February 15, 1975, and 715 aircrafts were delivered between October 1975 and March 1984. The fleet was modernized under the Precision Engagement Program, resulting in the A-10C, which first flew at Eglin in 2005. Design, features, and capabilities. The A-10 is 53 feet 4 inches long, 14 feet 8 inches high, has a wingspan of 57 feet 6 inches, and it can weigh 51,000 pounds at its heaviest. The aircraft is designed to be refueled, rearmed, and serviced with minimal equipment. Its simple design enables maintenance at forward bases with limited facilities. An unusual feature is that many of the aircraft's parts are interchangeable between the left and right sides, including the engines, main landing gear, and vertical stabilizers. The A-10 has a cantilever low-wing monoplane wing with a wide cord. The leading edge of the wing has a honeycomb structure panel construction, providing strength with minimal weight. The A-10 offers excellent maneuverability at low air speeds and altitude, while maintaining a highly accurate weapons delivery platform. They can loiter near battle areas for extended periods of time, are capable of austere landings, 1,000-foot ceilings, with 1.5-mile visibility. Additionally, with the capability of carrying precision-guided munitions and unguided munitions, they can employ above, below, and in the weather. Their wide combat radius and short takeoff and landing capability permit operations in and out of locations near front lines. Thunderbolt have night vision imaging systems, or NVIS, goggle-compatible single-seat cockpits forward of their wings, helmet-mounted cueing systems, and a large bubble canopy which provides pilots all-around vision. The cockpit and parts of the flight control systems are protected by 1,200 pounds of titanium aircraft armor, referred to as a bathtub. The armor has been tested to withstand strikes from 23mm cannon fire and some indirect hits from 57mm shell fragments. Weapons and armament. The A-10 aircraft has 11 store pylons, providing an external load capacity of 7,260 kilograms. Three pylons are under the fuselage, and the loads can be configured to use either the centerline pylon or the two flanking fuselage pylons. For weapon guidance, the aircraft can be fitted with Pave Penny laser guidance and a pod installed on the starboard fuselage pylon. The A10's primary built-in weapon is the 30-173mm GAU-8A Avenger autocannon. One of the most powerful aircraft cannons ever flown, the GAU-8 is a hydraulically driven 7-barrel rotary cannon designed for the anti-tank role with a high rate of fire. Using the cannon, the A10 can disable a main battle tank from a range of more than 6,500 meters. The cannon can fire a range of ammunition, including armor-piercing incendiary rounds, weighing up to 0.75 kilograms, or uranium-depleted 0.43 kilograms API rounds. The magazine can hold 1,350 rounds of ammunition. And the pilot can select a firing rate of either 2,100 or 4,200 rounds a minute. The Thunderbolt II can also employ a wide variety of conventional munitions, including general-purpose bombs, cluster bomb units, laser-guided bombs, rockets, illumination flares, joint direct attack munitions or JDAM, wind-corrected munitions dispenser or WCMD, AGM-65 Maverick and AIM-9 Sidewinder missiles. Engine and performance. The A10 Warthog is powered by two TF-34 GE-100 non-afterburning turbofan engines. Each provide 9,065 pounds of thrust. The location of the engines, high on the fuselage, allows the pilot to fly the aircraft with one inoperable engine. The aircraft has a standard range of 800 miles and a maximum speed of 420 miles per hour. It can reach an altitude of 45,000 feet. It typically flies at a relatively low speed of 350 miles per hour, which makes it a better platform for the ground attack role than fast fighter bombers, which often have difficulty targeting small, slow-moving targets. The A-10 has been slated for retirement a number of times over the past 40 years, and each time it's managed to not only survive, but emerge with more capabilities. It has been highly regarded for its effectiveness in this role. Looking at its history, achievements, and capabilities, there is no doubt that the A-10 Thunderbolt II is one of the baddest plane ever built. It can take direct fire and keep on flying. And some of them even came back from combat with portions of the wing missing.